Ocean County, Mike City, Dojo, San Diego is celebrating its 5th anniversary today. We're ever grateful to the Jing Institute, more specifically Chris and Jing Jing. We can get them out on the floor. Chris, Jing Jing. Let's cheer them all out, Chris and Jing Jing. Right now, you're working through the 5 elements. Let's bowl. Japanese for fundamental principles, and there are 8. This is Motenyaku, which means outside twist. This is Urayaku, meaning inside twist. Capture the order. Finally, we see Musodorin, which means twin warrior catcher. Now I turn the floor over to our sensei, Bill Stegner.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bill Stegner. I'm the head instructor here at Kyokushinkan Taiko City Dojo San Diego. So what we're going to do next is we decided to do something completely different. Normally we script these demonstrations. However, this year what we're going to do is we're going to go off script. So what I'm going to do is we're going to talk about what you just saw. And so it's always hard going on after Jinjin, of course, with all the cool music and stuff. But we're narrating this so that you can get an understanding of what the art is and how powerful the art is and how it's employed. Right? So for example, Sho's going to start punching me back. And so, what you just saw them do, you're going to see me do the different movements and techniques that they just did. You follow me now? So, what our training is broken into training and fundamental principles. For example, that outside wrist grasp you just saw Stephanie and Sho just do, this is it. Okay? Okay? So, as we learn how the body works, where the body is vulnerable, we can move freely in the space that's provided and created as the two opponents dance with each other. For example, punch comes, certain possibilities exist because of where he's at, where I'm at, and the physicality involved in us as human beings. Does that make sense? And for example, his hand is here. Not anything can happen in a fight, despite what you see in Hollywood. Okay, how do you protect yourself in a lethal force encounter? You have to start studying, grasping what is possible so you plan for not what an opponent can do, what he's capable of doing. For example, here, he punches, I pull his punch towards me. This hand, I don't have to worry about him attacking anymore. This leg, I don't have to worry about him attacking anymore. Make sense? So the only thing I have to prepare for is this hand and this leg. Okay? So for example, that punch comes back this way. Yes? Okay, the Kido and Hakko are the way they are because the human body is the way it is. So it allows us, it gives us skills to deal with certain situations. Yes? So as he grasps my sleeve, that's a case I can be in. If he grabs my lapel, I'll do something different. Does that make sense? Okay? Yes. Right. Now you notice, it doesn't take speed, power, strength to actually work these techniques. Right? But all it does is take an understanding of how the human body works. Right? Right? Relax out. Yeah. Sean, please. So now also we work on things called balance, time, and distance. So you notice how I angle? What this does is it funnels the opponent into me. For example, as a boxer, you guys see a lot of MMA stuff? Well, we trained to this lunge punch. Because if he was a boxer, he'd lead with his left. Then he'd probably do a cross with his right. Does that make sense? So here, what I do, I force him in to drawing this punch. Yeah? Does that make sense? Okay? Also, one very important thing to understand is there's two sides of balance, timing, and distance. Right? There's mine and there's his. So I have to learn to control mine, use mine to control his. See the shift, the weight shift here? How it starts taking his balance to where I'm in control of it. Make sense? Then something like that. Right? Now what that does is it puts me in a superior position. So if we were in combat, then I can break contact and escape if I need to, which is the preferred method. Sometimes you can escape, right? You're forced to just deal with the situation. Yeah. Here. Yeah. Does that make sense? Okay. One more. Yeah. Now the punch. Good. Now here. Punch. Working multiple things at the same time. I'm actually attacking his elbow. Then from there I drop my weight. Yeah. Does that make sense? So you're dealing with multiple things at the same time. One important thing to understand about the art is it doesn't require strength or speed. You notice I'm not moving very fast. Sean is moving fast, right? Watch. Yeah? Now watch me move, right? Not much. Yeah? From here. So all that sunshine you saw earlier, remember that? This time of work? Next step? This work? Yeah? This one? Remember this one? Yeah? You guys follow me on that? Okay? This is how a smaller person can defeat a larger person. This is also how you can defeat someone in armor. Right? This one. See how this works? So now, if he was wearing armor, ancient or modern armor, punching him here would do nothing. Punching him in the face is problematic. He ducks his head, bam, breaks my head. So maybe here. Yes? This way. So effect is balanced, yeah? Like that. Also, if I'm loaded in armor, I'm not going to be able to move that fast. Right? There's individuals in this room who actually war, they fight wars for us. So they have to deal with this reality. Yeah? So if I'm heavy, this is how I'll move. Right? Make sense? Here, take his vision. Take his ability to act in this space. Does that make sense? Right? Okay, Sean? So later on we're going to come on and we're going to do some weapons, have some screw. Okay? Alright, so good.